गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट। आपके स्कूल बंद है लेकिन फिर भी पढ़ाई चल रही है, और वो भी कितने मजे से। ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन आप लोगों का वर्चुअल क्लास के थ्रू मैं आप लोगों का स्वागत करती हूँ। तो चलिए आज का हम कोट देखते हैं, द कोट ऑफ द डे। डिफिकल्ट रोड्स ऑलवेज लीड्स टू ब्यूटिफुल डेस्टिनेशन। यानी ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन पहले हम लोगों को कितना डिफिकल्ट लगता था, लेकिन अब हम लोग ऑनलाइन पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं तो कितने ब्यूटीफुली, कितने अच्छे से हमारी पढ़ाई हो रही है। कोई भी मुश्किल रास्ता जो होता है, हमको लगता है कि वो मुश्किल है, लेकिन हमेशा वो एक खूबसूरत मंजिल पर ले जाता है। तो देखते हैं, आज म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ ग्रेटर मुंबई एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट वर्चुअल क्लास की तरफ से आपका ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन जो हो रहा है, उसमें मैं आपकी दोस्त जरीना अब्दुल रहमान परकार, कस्तूरबा क्रॉस रोड नंबर 2, मुंबई पब्लिक उर्दू स्कूल बोरीवली ईस्ट से आपके 7th स्टैंडर्ड का मैथमेटिक्स का लेसन, जो हमने पिछली बार एक हिस्सा कर लिया था, उसका सेकेंड पार्ट आज हम करेंगे, अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस एंड ऑपरेशन। सो टुडे यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न, आफ्टर दिस लेसन यू विल बी एबल टू ऐड एंड सब्ट्रैक्ट द अलजेब्रिक टर्म्स एंड एक्सप्रेशंस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन सी सम पिक्चर्स ऑन योर स्क्रीन। ये तो आपकी रोज की जिंदगी में आप देखते होंगे। सो इफ देर आर 3 बैट्स एंड समबडी गिव यू 2 मोर बैट, सो टुगेदर इट बिकम्स 5 बैट्स। दिस यू हैव लर्न इन योर स्मॉल क्लास, स्टैंडर्ड 1 और 2। अगेन ओवर हियर, इफ एनीबडी गिव्स यू 2 एप्पल एंड समबडी गिव्स यू 2 मोर एप्पल्स, so you will be having all together 4 apples. So this operations we are doing right from 1st standard 2nd standard 3rd standard. Now we have grown up, ab hum bade ho gaye hain. So suppose we don't know the things, so we use some alphabets that we have seen last time. So this is coefficient 4 and x is along with it. So if we want to add an expression that is monomial 4x plus 3x, these both are monomial. In last class we have learned monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial. So first we are going to see how we will add monomial to monomial. There is a rule, the alphabet should be same. If there is x, then in the other monomial there should be x, then only we can add such type of monomials. These are like monomials, but this also we have seen last time. So for like monomials, what we will do, we will write the alphabet only once and we will add only the coefficient. We will add only the coefficient. Okay, so here 4 plus 3 will become 7, and the multiple we will write only once, that is x. So again in next example we can see it is in fraction. So here you have to see the denominator of the fraction. If the denominator of the fractions are same, we can add them directly. So here we will add only the numerator, 11 plus 3, that will become 14, and we will write denominator 8. So here also you have to concentrate, the multiples should be same. Here AB and here also AB. So both the multiples are same, then only we can add these two monomials which are like monomials. So it will become 14 upon 8 AB. Now see next. We are going to add now binomial expressions, addition of binomial expressions. There are two methods of adding binomial expressions, either by horizontal arrangement or by vertical arrangement. So let's see. Horizontal arrangement, if two binomials are to be added, this is one binomial and this is other binomial. So what we have to do, first we will open the bracket and we will write all the expressions in one line, and then we will gather all the like terms. See, this is x and this is x, so this is two like terms. So we will gather two like terms together and y, these two like terms together. Now the next step is same as before. We have to add the coefficient of like term. So like terms coefficients are 5 plus 2. Over here like terms coefficients are 4 and 3. So the addition of 5 and 2 will be 7. The addition of 4 and 3 will be 7. So your answer will be 7x plus 7y. Now similarly, if you see in vertical arrangement, you will arrange the binomial vertically, one above the other. So as we add the numbers, here also we have to put a line, and below that we have to add like terms. Here there is no rule that you have to add from right side or left side. You can add any way. So you can add first 4y plus 3y or you can add 5x plus 2x. Both the way you can add. Only thing is that you have to see the like terms and you will add it. So isn't it easy? So what is the rule? To add like terms, we add their coefficient and write their variable as it is after their sum. So these are the variables we are writing, or multiples we can say, as it is we have to write. Only once we will write the variable. So here also this is horizontal method and this is vertical method. So I feel you have understood it very easily. Only thing you have to concentrate, you have to gather like terms and then you will add the coefficient of it. And the variable will be written over here as it is. Only once you will write variable over here, once only. And after adding the numbers, you will write that same variable beside that. Here also, after adding these two numbers, you will write the variable beside that. So you have to remember that to add like terms, we add their coefficient and write their variables as it is after their sum. After their sum, we are writing this variable only once as it is. So see next. Now addition of trinomial. Similarly, how we have added the binomial, now we'll add trinomial. You can see there are three terms here, 1, 2, 3. So it is a trinomial, and we are adding this trinomial in another trinomial, 1, 2, 3. So here also same rule, we have to write removing the bracket, then we will gather all the like terms. See, x, the brother of x is x only, so you will gather them in one house. This is a like term house, x house. This is now y term, and this is y term house. So all brothers of y's are here. Then this is z house, all brother and sister of z. Here we will gather together. So like they are of same like terms, they are living in same house. Here it is Y house and this is Z house. Okay, now what is next? We will write the coefficient. So you will add only the coefficient and you will write the variable over here once only beside it. Here also you will add the coefficient and variable once beside it. Coefficient addition and variable once. Now we'll see the sum of 16 plus 9 will be 25, 23 plus 27 will be 50, and 12 and 14 will be 26. So we have added all the coefficient and we have written variable once beside it. Same rule as it was in binomial. So this is your resulting final answer of your trinomial, addition of trinomial. So this was the horizontal method. Now we'll see how we are adding in vertical method. You will write both the trinomials one above the other and then the method of addition. You will draw a line and then you will add the like terms. Here you can either start from this or you can start from here. There is no rule as our simple addition because here there is no unit tens and hundreds. This is like term, this is Z terms, this is Y term and this is X term. So we have to add the same term below that. Y term below Y term, X term is below X term. You have to add only the coefficient and the variable once as it is. You will add the coefficient and the variable once as it is. Okay, so I think you might have understood very well. I repeat again and again that as in binomial, here also you have to add the coefficient and you will write the variable once as it is beside the sum of the coefficient, beside the sum of the coefficient, beside the sum of the coefficient, sum of the coefficient, you will write variable only once as it is. Now see next. Now we have added all the expressions, monomial, binomial and trinomial. Now see how we have to subtract it. Likewise in addition, here I have 5 balls and somebody have taken 3 balls from me. So only 2 balls are remaining with me now. So again over here, 4 mangoes. My mummy gave me 4 mangoes and my sister took 3 mangoes from me. So only 1 mango is left with me. So similarly over here, in algebraic expression, monomial, if there is 5x and we are going to subtract 3x from it, same rule as it was in addition, you have to write the subtraction of coefficient and the variable as it is. The multiple will be here as it is. You will subtract the coefficient, 5 minus 3 will be 2x and the variable will be written as it is. Similarly, if it is in fraction, again over here, you can see the denominators are same. So you will write same denominator for the answer. You will subtract only the numerator. So 8 minus 10 will be 2. So your answer will be 2 upon 6 AB. So whatever coefficient variable is written over there, you will write as it is. So you might have got this point. The same rule for addition and subtraction. Only thing is that you have to add, if it is addition of algebraic expression, you have to add the coefficient and you will subtract the algebraic expressions. coefficient if it is subtraction. Now see next, we will see the subtraction of binomial. Now first we will see vertical method arrangement. Same way how we have written for addition, you will write one above the other the two binomials. Here only one thing you have to keep in mind, when there is a subtraction, the sign of second binomial will change. There is no sign means there is a plus sign, so it will change to minus sign. And when there is a minus sign, it will change to plus sign. Now we don't consider this sign, we have to consider this sign only. So we have to subtract 8. We have to do subtraction between 8 and 5. So when 5 is subtracted from 8, we will get 3. So 8 is a bigger number, its sign is positive, so the answer is positive. Now here we can see that this sign is minus and this is plus. So these are opposite sign. When there are opposite sign, we have to subtract. So we will subtract 2 from 7. So after subtracting 2 from 7, we get 5. We will write 5 here and the sign of greater number. Now the greater number is negative. Greater number is 7. 2 is a small number. So greater number has negative sign, therefore we have to put negative sign in answer. So here also greater number sign is positive, when there is no sign means it is positive. So we have put it over here positive sign, when there is no sign it is positive. So you might have understood properly. I repeat again and again, when you do subtraction, the sign of second binomial will change. If it is positive, means there is no sign, it is positive, it will change into negative. And the negative sign will change into positive. Then you have to consider these two signs. You don't have to consider this sign and this sign. So it will be 8 minus 5. So it will be 3. 8 minus 5 is 3. Now here again 7 and 2 are in opposite sign. 7 is negative and 2 is positive. So 7 minus 2 will be 5. And you have to put the sign of greater number. So this you have to remember. You don't have to do any mistake when you are subtracting. Now it is easy in horizontal method. See what happens in horizontal method. First binomial will be written as it is, and when you are opening the bracket, that time when there is a minus sign outside the bracket, you have to change the sign inside the bracket monomial. So here we'll see how it gets changed. See, this will remain as it is 8x, this will remain as it is as minus 7y. Here the sign change. See, you have seen over here. It is now minus 5x and now it is plus 2y. Minus, minus, plus. So now you have got my point. Yes. So the next step is same. You have to gather like terms. So it is 8x and 5x. If it is minus sign in between, we have to put minus sign, and then it is minus 7y and plus 2y. Here again you have to write the coefficient together and the variable beside it. It will be 8 minus 5x minus 7 plus 2y. So what happens if we subtract? Here it will comes to 3x, and this will 7 minus 2 will be 5, and the sign of greater number. So Here, to add like terms, we add their coefficient and write their variable as it is after their sum. Similarly, when we subtract it, we have to subtract and we have to write the variable as it is beside it. So, now see in next one, subtraction of trinomial. Same way as we have done addition. Now here it is a subtraction of trinomial. You can see over here clearly. Say this is one term, second term, third term, 1, 2, 3. So you will write second step. You will open the bracket. Now see here sign changed. Minus sign, minus, plus, minus. Again over here, minus, minus, plus. Again over here, minus, minus, plus. So this two sign, all three signs have been changed. The next step is we are gathering all the like terms. So we have gathered all the like terms. Then we are writing only the coefficient and the variable beside it. Here also we have gathered the coefficient. Here the coefficient. Here also the coefficient and the variable once beside it. So 13 minus 7 will be 6x, 8 minus 3 will be 5, minus sign is outside, so we'll put minus sign over here. Again 11 minus 6 will be 5, minus sign is here, so we'll write minus sign over here. Now we'll see in vertical arrangement. We will write first trinomial and second trinomial one above the other. Write how I have shown you in last binomial. The rule will be same. When minus sign is there, you have to change the sign of second trinomial. When there is no sign, means it is plus positive, it will change to negative. When it is negative, you have to change into positive. When it is negative, you have to change into positive. Now we will consider this sign, not this sign. So 3, 13 minus 7, we will do 13 minus 7. 13 minus 7. So 13 minus 7 comes to 6 and the variable once beside it. Now here 8 is negative and 3 is positive now. So we have to subtract. So 8 minus 3 will be 5 and the sign of greater number is negative. So the answer will be negative. So it will be negative 5 and the variable once beside it. Again over here 11 is negative and 6 will convert it into positive. So 11 minus 6 will be 5 and the sign of the greater number. The greater number is 11. So we'll put the sign of greater number in the answer. So friends, you have understood the addition and subtraction of monomial, binomial and trinomial. Now we will repeat this one more time. You will understand it very nicely. We have seen the addition of monomial. We have added only the coefficient and the variable ones beside it. Then we have seen the horizontal arrangement and the vertical arrangement of addition of binomial. Here also we have written the like terms together and we have added the coefficient of it and then we have written the variable ones beside it. Similarly, in vertical arrangement, we have added the coefficient and we have written the variable ones beside it. Added the coefficient and the variable ones beside it. Next, in addition of trinomial, we have seen how we have written the all the terms and then we have gathered the like terms and then we have added the coefficient and we have written the variable ones beside it. Similarly, over here in vertical arrangement, we have added the coefficient and we have written the variable ones beside it. So, same rule for the subtraction. Subtraction, we have subtracted the monomials. Here also we have subtracted the coefficient and we have written the variable ones beside it. Either it is in fraction, we have subtracted the fraction and then we have written the variable ones beside it. Similarly, for binomial, only thing I have to point out again and again, for binomial subtraction or trinomial subtraction, you have to change the sign of the second. The first one will remain as it is. So here in horizontal arrangement, when you open the bracket, you will change the sign of the binomial inside it. And then the second next step will be the same. You will gather and you will subtract it. For trinomial, it is same. So after looking all these things, now we'll evaluate ourselves. So are you ready for evaluation? Yes. You might have understood how to add 3A and 5A. Wait. Don't be hurry. See it, observe it carefully and then you will answer it. See, it is monomial 3A plus 5A. So, you have to add only the coefficient and you will write variable ones beside it. So, can you answer? What will be the answer for this? 3A plus 5A? Yes, it is 8A. You are right. Very good. Now, for the next monomial, we'll see. It is 8x square and 9x square. So, whatever variable is, you will write that variable once only. Only you have to remember that you have to add only the coefficient. It is very easy. So, who will answer for this? Yes, try yourself. Yes, you will add only the coefficient. So, the answer will be, yes, the answer is 17x square. 9 plus 8 will be 17. Now, for third one. So, whatever variable is, you will write that variable as it is. Only you have to concentrate on coefficient. So, addition of this. So, what will be the answer again over here? Yes, now you got my point. It is 11ab square because 7 plus 4 is 11. Now, for this fraction, no need to hesitate. Darne ki koi baat nahi hai. See the concentrate on the denominator. The denominators are same. Here also 9, here also 9. So, in answer, the denominator will be 9. What you have to do? Only you have to add the numerator. Yes, now you got my point. So many of you know the answers now. So, what will be the answer of this? Yes, you are right. It is 7 upon 9 ZB square. Oh, now it is root. What to do with root? No problem. See, I will give you one clue. It is 1 time root 3 and 1 more time root 3. So, 1 and 1. 1 plus 1 is? Yes, very good. So, it is very simple. It is 2 time root 3. So, and variable beside is as it is. So, darne ki koi baat nahi hai. Agar fraction bhi aa jaye, toh bhi aapko kaise karna hai? I have shown you the idea. You have to concentrate on the denominator and write the denominator as it. Only you have to add the numerator. See, it is very easy. In root also, it is one root, one time root 3, one time root 3. So it will be 2 time root 3, 2 root 3, and the variable beside it. Very good student, you have given a correct answer. Now we'll check for the binomial. Over here, again, you have to see only the like terms, 4xy and 7xy. So the coefficient variable will be same. You have to add only the coefficient 7 plus 4. And for this, 2a square c, 5a square c. Again over here, variable as it is, only you have to add the coefficient 2 plus 5. So what will be the answer? Think over, come on. Yes. Oh, you got the point. See, the answer is 7 plus 4 is 11 and 5 plus 2 is 7. Only you have to write whatever variable beside it. Now for second question, now you got the thing. Same way you have to do. No need of hesitation. If it is number, you will add number to number. If it is fraction, you will add fraction to fraction. Only in fraction you have to concentrate on denominator. If the denominators are same, then you will add only the numerator. So what will be the addition of 9 and 3? Yes. And 2 and 3? Yes. Now you will get the point. Now you are able to answer this also. I have confidence. Yes. Very good. It is 12x square plus 5 upon 7x square. Okay. So here you can feel that both the variables are same. Then why we cannot add this? Here, even you can add this further. But for your, here we will stop. Now for the next one. It is 6ab square root 5z square. Again over here, root 5 ko dekh kar darna nahi bilkul. Waisa hi karna hai, same. See, you will add this 6 into 3. 6 plus 3 will be, yes. And 1 time root 5. And 1 time root 5. So, how many times? Yes, you are right. The answer will be 9ab square and 2 time root 5. Now, dear friends, you are grown up. Now, we'll go further. Now we'll see addition of trinomial. Similarly over here, only you have to add the coefficient and you will get the answer. Now you can answer for this. When there is nothing written over here, it means it is 1. So you have to see it is 1. I repeat again, it is 1. So 4 plus 1. So now you have got the point. And what will be the answer for this? Yes, it is 6. 2 plus 4 is 6xy. 7 plus 2 is 9z square. And 4 plus 1 is 5x square. Okay. Now here also in fractions, either it is fraction or it is root. Now I know you have become expert. Now you don't hesitate. I know you got the answer also. Yes, the answer is 6 upon 7x square, 2 time root 3, and this is 5 plus 2, 7. Yes, very good student. Now we'll see the subtraction. Come on, now you do it fast. Now you have to subtract smaller number from bigger number. So what will be the answer? Yes, and you will put the sign of bigger number. So your answer will be, Yes, your answer will be minus 4x square. Now here you will add smaller number from bigger number. Again, smaller number from bigger number. So 9 minus 7 will be yes. And here there is no sign, means it is positive. So your answer will be correct. You are very right. It is 2x square y cube. Next, now it is in fraction. Here, same way, you have to subtract smaller number from bigger number. You will subtract 3 from 6. So 6 minus 3 will be yes. And the denominator will be same. And the variable also will be same. So your answer is yes. Minus 3 upon 8ab. Because the greater number sign is negative. Okay. Now we'll see the subtraction of binomial. Again over here. Now you have seen. Yes. Now you are very smart. Answer for the third. Yes. Oh, here. Got the correct answer. How you have got this correct answer? See, because this is positive root and this will become negative root. So, plus 2 root and minus 2 root will become 0. So, you will have only the subtraction of 6 minus 5. 6 minus 5 is 1. So, students, you have got my point. You will go through all the sums and all the evaluation. You will get the answers. And there is assignment for you. You can take a screenshot of it or you can visit this video again and again. And you will solve all these questions. This is addition, addition of binomial, binomial and addition. Over here, it is somewhere binomial also and trinomial also. So, now it is easy for you to add and subtract monomial, binomial, trinomial or polynomial. I have confidence that you will do it properly. Only thing is that you have to gather the like terms and then you will, if it is add, you have to add it. If it is subtract, you have to subtract it. In addition, you have to add the coefficient. In subtraction, you have to subtract the coefficient. Okay, students, so I feel you have got my point. And now it is very easy for you. And if it is there that you don't understand any point of it, it is very good that you are studying online. So there is no problem. You can visit again and again and you can solve your point where you have not understood. So thank you, student. I feel you might have enjoyed the lesson very much and you will do all the sums of assignment. Thank you. Bye-bye.